Hi, I'm Ram Gopal from presentationprocess.com. In this video, you will learn a beautiful photo flip effect using PowerPoint morph transition. You can use this effect to talk about details regarding photos. The beautiful photo flip effect using PowerPoint morph transition looks like this. As you can see, we have three photos. The details of the three photos are behind the photos. When we click, we reveal the details about the first photo, and then about the second photo, and then about the third photo. This is the effect you will learn to create. Of course, you can replace the pictures of flowers with mugshots of employees, and you can provide details regarding those employees here. This is a fairly versatile layout you can use in any number of situations. Let us learn how to create this beautiful effect from scratch. Before I show you how to create the layout, let me show you the principle behind how the layout works. So let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery and pick up a block arrow. Let me choose this one, and this is the arrow we are going to work with. Let us change the color to something like teal color. Let us have a duplicate of this. Maybe I can keep a duplicate over here, and let us give this a different color, maybe orange color. Now, let us select both these arrows, right-click, go to Format Object, and let us go to Effects option, and let us use 3D Rotation option, and the first thing we need to do is to give this a perspective. To give this a perspective, all we need to do is to go to Presets in 3D Rotation and use the first one called as Perspective Front, which adds 45 degrees perspective to these graphics. Now, this is essential so that the rotation effect actually shows. The next thing we need to do is to have these flip from right to left. For that, we need to change the X rotation to 180 degrees. So this is what we have on the first slide. Let us duplicate this slide. And this time, I'm going to select both of these. Go to the same effects option. And let me keep everything else the same, only that the X rotation is going to be 0 instead of 180 degrees. And all we have done is in the first one, we have flipped it by 180 degrees. And in the second one, we removed the flip. That is all we did. Now, let us go to transitions. And to the second one, I'm going to apply morph transition. And let us go to the first one, go to the slideshow, and see how the effect works. First, you can see that we have the arrows facing left. On a click, we have the arrows facing right. This is the first principle. Let us go to the first slide and let us have both the arrows stacked one on top of the other. So if I have to have the orange here to be in the front, let me right click and bring it to front and let me place this over the teal arrow. And in the second one, I'm going to have the teal arrow to the front. So right click and bring to front and let us bring this behind and let us align both of them properly. And when I go to the first one and when I go to slideshow mode, see how the arrow is facing to the left and what you see here is orange arrow. On a click, the other side is shown, which is the teal arrow. So this is the basic principle behind the photo flip effect that I just showed you. Now, let me show you how I created the layout with multiple photo flip effects. Here I have a new presentation, and you can see that we have the three photos that we worked with earlier. We have the details of these three photos behind these. To see them, you just need to select all this. Let me press Ctrl X just to show you that we have these elements behind. Let me press Ctrl V to paste this back on top of them, and now we have got our setup in place. The first step is to select these two items, that is the picture and the associated details. Right click, go to Format Object, and in 3D Rotation, the first thing I need to do is to go to Presets, and from Perspective, let me apply Perspective Front. Then, you can see we have Perspective 45 degrees shown here. Let us go to X Rotation and flip it laterally by using 180 degrees and hit Enter. Now we have got our picture and the explanation flipped 180 degrees. Then let us duplicate this slide. And in the second slide, let us select both of these. Go to 3D rotation again. And X rotation needs to be 0 degrees and hit enter. Perspective remains at 45 degrees. So we have done the reverse of the flipping that we did in the earlier slide. Now we need to send this picture behind. So I'm going to select this and say send to back. Now we have the photo details shown to the front. Now if I were to apply morph transition to the second slide by going to transitions and morph transition, you can see that we have the flip happening pretty beautifully. Now in the second slide, I'm going to set up for the next slide as well. So I'm going to select these two elements, that is this picture and its associated explanation. Go to 3D rotation and first perspective and perspective front. Then let us go to X rotation and say 180 degrees and hit enter. Now this is flipped. So the second slide not just reveals the details of the first photo, but also provides the setup for the second flip. Then let us duplicate this slide. And here we are going to unflip whatever that we had done earlier. So let us select both these. Go to 3D rotation and the perspective still remains at 45 degrees and X rotation is 0 degrees and hit enter, and you send this picture behind by right clicking and using send to back option, and we have the second details shown. Then while these details are revealed, we will set up for the next slide as well. So let us select both these, go to presets, perspective, perspective front, X rotation and say 180 degrees and hit enter, and then let us duplicate the slide by right clicking and using duplicate slide option, and here we will do unflipping of that by going to X rotation and say 0 degrees and hit enter, and let us select this, right click and send to back, and we have the third photo details shown. Now since we are just duplicating the morph transition that we had earlier applied, we don't have to apply morph transition for the remaining slides. They are already applied. Now when I go to the first slide and go to slideshow mode, you can see we have this element flipped, only that you don't really know that it has been flipped. On a click, you can see we have details of the first picture shown. Now what you fail to notice is, while the details of the first photo are revealed, the second photo is flipped. Now on a click, we have unflipping happening and we have the details of the second photo shown. And while this is happening, the third photo is flipped. On a click, we have unflipping of that and we have the photo details shown. It is such a beautiful effect and it will definitely captivate your audience. Now there is no doubt that you can create the same kind of effect using custom animation with a combination of collapse and stretch animations. I've shown you how to do that in two of my earlier videos. The first one called How to Create an Easy Flipbook Animation PowerPoint. If you have not watched that video, I highly recommend that you watch it. There is another useful video that uses the same technique called as Number Flip Animation in PowerPoint 2013. This is a slightly dated video, but then the technique remains the same. So you can watch two other videos to understand all about flip, whether it is using custom animation, or you can of course follow the video that I had just shown you that details how to create the same effect using morph transition. As you can see, what you can create in PowerPoint is limited only by your imagination. There are so many ways to achieve the same objective, and there are so many creative tools in PowerPoint that you can really take your presentations to the next level. And if you want to do so, I highly recommend you join our Ram Gopal's PowerPoint Mastery Program. It is the most comprehensive and creative PowerPoint training program online. I will leave a link to this product in the description box below the video. You can click on the link, come check out this video, and if you think that this is the right product for you, you can always enroll to the program and take your PowerPoint skills to the next level. Finally, if you want to get access to free mini training courses on PowerPoint that I share only with my newsletter subscribers, you can click on the link here and join our newsletter and enjoy this practical and useful content. Thanks a lot for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one.